I'm with Roz Rosatar, analyst with ITSM Review, amongst others. Welcome to the ITSMF event. And just really wanted to ask you about, you know, what sort of things you're doing with at ITSM Review at the moment. Kind of projects you've got on and what that involves to look at the market.
The biggest thing for this year is a year's plan of reviews. So it's kicking off with incident and problem in this quarter. Then I think we've got knowledge management, change in config, and integrations, and hopefully setting up to look at slightly different things, but, you know, rather than just focusing on what the tool and the bog standard processes look at.
Okay, and what sort of approach do you normally take in terms of looking at vendors and looking at their products? How do you assess them?
For the process ones, it's been mostly about trying to get them to drive specific scenarios. It's very difficult to actually assess a tool in 1.5 hours of a demo across the piece. So we've had to split them by process, which might not be the best way of doing it, but it seems to be the only way to actually make people think about what they want to promote for their tool.
Okay, and do you look at the vendor as well, or is it just the tool? I mean, in terms of their capability, delivery capability, that kind of stuff?
This year, we're trying to sort of push more towards looking at what they do. When we did the first one last year with Request Fulfillment, what I found was really refreshing was people were willing to share their the way in which they bind their consultancy around the tool. We weren't expecting that, and it was actually a refreshing approach. So this year I want to really try and focus more on the value add that you get, as well as the bog standard tool doing stuff. Because at the end of the day, all the tool does is push a ticket through.
And so that goes out on the ITSM Review website.
Yep.
I mean, is that something that is open to everybody, or is it subscription, or how does it work?
The ITSM website is free, but you can subscribe for newsletters. So, okay. And hopefully with the subscriptions, we're going to try and pull in some white papers. One of the white papers I'm hopefully working on is, you know, the ins and outs of how to write the perfect RFP. So, you know, that's one of my pet projects.
Just on that topic, what would be your kind of couple of tips for the perfect RFP?
I'll say what I used to say when I used to work for IBM. Decide what you want the tool to do, then ditch that and actually look at what it is that you need to do. Because quite often you'll find that wants and needs do diverge. Get a very, very good end-to-end architect to help you look across the piece, not just the service management.
So not just about functionality.
Correct.
Okay, and what other things in this market do you think people tend to do, you know, maybe that doesn't help them to find the right tool? Are there any tips for this market?
I think the obvious go-to is looking at the verification sort of criteria for tooling. I think most people start there because they think that's a leveler. And it is, because you'll have people with more certification than others. But
Pink Verify,
the Cabinet Office.
Yeah.
But really, you know, you would expect any tool to be able to push a ticket through its life cycle.
Yeah.
What you really want to look at is what you're going to get. To quote Patrick Bolger, what do you do once we've left you with this? What can you do afterwards? That's what you really need to look at, not how to just push the ticket through.
Okay. Well, I look forward to seeing the reviews on the ITSM Review. Roz, thank you very much.
Okay.